Okay, I'll just leave it, I'll just leave the recording in progress, and then I don't have to worry about returning it on.
Well, you don't forget it, right?
That's right.
That's happened to me once, or twice.
Okay, so this is your chance to chatter, because I'm not editing it.
Yes, right.
Keep it clean now.
The verbiage between the songs was disappearing, so last week she didn't take anything out. And if you don't like that, then she can go back to editing, but it's a whole lot easier to just post the whole thing.
It went really fast.
Your voice is very faint, Harvey, you guys. Is there a...
Should I get closer to the mic?
That would help. For a bunch of deaf old people.
Yeah.
How about me?
I don't like to stand too close to the mic. He's not my kind of guy.
Ba-dum-bum.
So we still have a couple of minutes before we start. I'll make the announcement again in case, because a lot of people hadn't tuned in at the time. Kathleen Clark will not be joining us today because she's feeling a bit under the weather with a migraine. And I've already told her that we'll miss her and that I hope that she would feel better. She sent me an email.
Okay.
I'm not sure there's any other bookkeeping type control issues that need discussing. Except, of course, this is the first of 3 weeks that I'm going to be doing this. A short stint this time, because Sal has a short religious period.
That's 52 dozen songs.
What?
And then he will be back.
My brother once told me that one third of the year, of a calendar year, is taken up by Jewish holidays, events.
Yeah, but on some of them, you're actually allowed to listen to music.
Yeah.
The ones that I take over, Saul can't listen to music. So.
Is it really a third of the year? I would doubt it's that many.
Yep.
One holiday or the other. Some of them are pretty minor.
I grew up Reform. We don't know any of those holidays.
Yeah, exactly. But my brother is very religious. Well, was. But the rest of the family, family is very religious.
So, Bob, if you're Reform when you grow up and then you reform yourself, does that turn you into Orthodox?
It's still coming in low. What was the question?
If you grow up Reform... And then you reform yourself. Do you become Orthodox?
Yes.
I haven't reformed myself. No.
You haven't.
I'm a folk singer.
You haven't lived until you've attended a bar mitzvah of Patty O'Toole. You know. So, and I've done it. Okay, so you know, the world is changing, my friends. The world is changing.
All right. Well, it's 2. I don't see anybody waiting to be let in, so I'll announce the magic list here. The order of operations is Murray, Drew, George, Jerry, Mike Reeves, Bob Winkler, Susan and Bob, Debbie and Ron, Tricia, then Pat and me. And having said that, Murray, you can start up.
Okay. Get my paraphernalia.
Everybody mute.
Okay. Okay, the first song that I'm going to sing. Neither of the songs that I'm singing are really folk songs, but they're sort of, you know, they got sort of folkish melodies and stuff like that. The first one was written by Jerry Jeff Walker in 1968. and it's the song Mr. Bojangles. Okay, there's a lot of people who sang, who love that song, and they sang and sang it somewhere or other since 1968, including in this club. Okay, it's about a man, Bojangles. He calls himself Bojangles as his nickname, but he's not the same Bojangles, Bill Bojangles Robinson, that we know of, you know, and who made, you know, was famous for dancing and was in movies with Shirley Temple and other people, you know, dancing up and downstairs and doing things like that. This is a different Bojangles, who Jerry Jeff Walker met in a prison cell when Jerry Jeff Walker was young. And he was going somewhere in his car, and he did some kind of a violation to the traffic rules and was stopped by cops. And then he got into arguments with the cops instead of, you know, going along and paying respect or something. And they arrested him and put him in jail. I think it was the 4th of July weekend. So he had to stay in jail about 4 days. And his cell partner was a guy who called himself Bojangles, you know, after the original Bojangles, and did some dance, you know, was a good dancer too, although somewhat inebriated. And that's what gave Jerry Jeff Walker the idea for the song. And the song has become a big hit for him. Okay. I knew a man, Bojangles, and he danced for you in worn out shoes with silver hair, a ragged shirt, and baggy pants. The old soft shoe, he jumped so high, jumped so high. Then he lightly touched down. Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles, dance. I met him in a cell in New Orleans. I was down and out. He looked to me to be the eyes of age. As he spoke right out, he talked of life, talked of life. He laughed, slapped his leg instead. He said the name Bojangles and he danced a lick across the cell. He grabbed his pants for better stance. Oh, he jumped so high. He clicked his heels. He let go a laugh. He let go a laugh. Shook back his clothes all around. Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles, dance. We dance for those at minstrel shows and county fairs throughout the South. We spoke in tears of 15 years how his dog and him traveled about. His dog up and died. He up and died. After 20 years, he still grieves. Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles, dance. They said I dance at every chance at honky and honky tonks for drinks and tips. And most of the time I spend behind these county bars. Course I drinks a bit. He shook his head, and as he shook his head, I heard someone ask, please, Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles.
Okay, thank you. Drew, I think you're up.
Yep. That was very nice, Murray. I like that. I haven't heard that song for quite a while.
Thank you.
I'm going to do a song by Irving Berlin, written in 1939. It's not a typical Irving Berlin song. It's called My Walking Stick. Now, a walking stick can either be a true walking stick or an umbrella. And I have reason to believe he's talking about his walking stick is an umbrella. Let's see. Here goes. Take away my high hat. Take away my favorite tie. Take away my wide spats, but I'll still get mine. But my walking stick, you simply must let that be. No, you can't take that away from me. Without my walking stick, I'd go insane. Can't look my best, I'd feel undressed without my cane. Must have my walking stick, for it may rain. When it pours, I can't be outdoors without my cane. If I should ever leave my house without my walking stick, well, that would be something I could never explain. And the thing that makes me click on Lover's Lane would go for naught if I was caught without my chain. Without my walking stick, I'd go insane. Can't look my best, I'd feel undressed without my cane. Must have my walking stick, for it may rain. When it pours, can't be outdoors without my cane. If I should ever leave my home without my walking stick, why, that would be something I could never explain. And the thing that makes me click on Lover's Lane would go for naught if I was caught without my cane. Would go for naught if I was caught without my cane.
Thank you, Drew. George, are you ready?
I am. Thank you, Harvey. This song is called Seven Daffodils. Was written by Lee Hayes and Fran Mosley, and the version that I'm going to sing is the one that was recorded by the Limeliters. If you know the song, I'm playing it in A minor. Do not have a mansion, I haven't any land, not one paper dollar to crinkle in my hand, but I can show you give you seven daffodils. I do not have a fortune to buy you pretty things, but I can weave you moonbeams for necklaces and rings, and I can show you mornings on a thousand hills, and kiss you and give you seven seven golden daffodils shining in the sun to light our way to evening when the day is done, and I will give you music and a crust of bread, a pillow of piney boughs to rest your head, a pillow of piney boughs to rest your head.
Lots of memories there.
I knew it by Jonathan Edwards.
I'm sure a lot of people have recorded it. That's just the version I always play.
Very nice, George. Jerry.
Okay. It's good to see everybody. I haven't seen you for a couple of weeks. And we're leaving for Wales tomorrow. We're going to go and visit our friend Ray outside of Cardiff, and spend all the nights in the pubs playing and singing and drinking excessive amounts of Guinness. A terrible way to go, but somebody's got to do it. So this tune I learned off a 1965 album by Judy Roderick. Judy Roderick was a wonderful white blues singer in the Village back in the 60s, who unfortunately died quite young. But I've never heard this tune anywhere else. I don't really know where the tune went after this, but it was written by Hi Heath and Johnny Lang, and it is one of the few threat songs that I know that really are quite effective. Let's see. They'll be walking slow behind you. They'll know just where to find you. If you don't leave my baby alone, there'll be flowers by the dozens from uncles, aunts, and cousins. When all your earthly trials have flown, well, they'll take you out to you know where and lay you in the shade, and then proceed to pat your ugly features with a spade. So allow me to remind you, they'll be walking slow behind you. Well, now Satan's going to claim you for his own, for his own. If you don't leave my baby alone, thank you. they'll cover you with violets they've gathered in the dell. And there'll be lots of flowers, but you think you'd be in shape to smell. Well, remind me to remind you, they'll be walking slow behind you. Friends will gather round to weep and moan. Weep and moan if you don't leave my baby alone. Yes, they will cover you with violets they've gathered in the dell. And there'll be lots of flowers, but you think you'll be in shape to smell. Well, remind me to remind you, they'll be walking slow behind you. Your friends will gather around to weep and moan. Weep and moan if you don't leave my baby alone. If you don't leave my baby alone. If you don't leave my baby alone.
Mike, you ready?
Yes, ready. Yeah, this is a song, The Ways of Men. I heard it recently, on YouTube recently, by one of our friends, Nina Ritchie. I don't know whether a few of you will remember she used to come and sing at the library. And in the introduction to the song, she mentions singing there. She mentions soul. She talks about Ed Trickett and what a gentleman he was. And it's rather nice. But actually, I've gone back to Anne May O'Muir version. Gordon Bock wrote it. The ways of man are passing strange. He buys his freedom and he counts his change. Then he lets the wind his days arrange, and he calls the tide his master. Oh, the days, oh, the days, oh, the fine long summer days. The fish come rolling in the bays, and he swore he'd never leave me. But the days grow short, and the year gets old, and the fish won't stay where the water's cold. And if they're going to fill the hold, they've got to go offshore to find them. Oh, the days, oh, the days, oh, the fine long summer days. The fish come rolling in the bays, and he swore he'd never leave me. So they go outside on the raving deep, and they pray the Lord their soul to keep. But the waves will roll them all to sleep, and the tide will be their keeper. Oh, the days, oh, the days, oh, the fine long summer days. The fish come rolling in the bays, and he swore he'd never leave me. Oh, the tide, oh, you dark and you bitter tide. If I can't have him by my side, I guess I'll have to leave him. I gave you one, I gave you two, the best that rotten old boat could do. You won't be happy till I've gave you three, but I'll be damned if you'll get me. Oh, the days, oh, the days, oh, the fine long summer days. The fish come rolling in the bays, and he swore he'd never leave me. Oh, the tide, oh, the tide, oh, you dark and you bitter tide. If I can't have him by my side, the water's welcome to him. Oh, Lord, I know that the day will come when one less boat comes slogging home. I don't mind knowing that he'll be the one, but I can't spend my whole life praying. Oh, the days, oh, the days, oh, the fine long summer days. The fish come rolling in the bays, and he swore he'd never leave me. I gave you one, I gave you two, the best that poor old boat could do. You'd have it all before you threw, well, I've got no more to give you. Oh, the days, oh, the days, oh, the fine long summer days. The fish come rolling in the bays, and he swore he'd never leave me. The ways of man are passing strange. He buys his freedom and he counts his change. Then he lets the wind his days arrange, and he calls the tide his master.
Good job.
It's a really nice song.
Yeah, well sung.
Very, very nice. Ah, Mr. Winkley, sir.
Good to be here, and I really mean it's good to be here. It's a day we get to step away from the real world, and music is always a good way to do it. It was so good to watch the opening ceremony of the Olympics for those that got to watch that. I'm not much for the Summer Olympics. I'm more of a Winter Olympics guy, but to watch Celine Dion do her cover of Edith Piaf's song, and I probably totally mispronounced this, the Hymn de l'Amour, there. That was just so moving, watching that, and God, I was just moved to tears. It just brought back so much for me. But back to just being here, to take us, this 3 hours we have, just to take us away from the real world for a bit of time, it's just something else. Anyway, so and to kind of go with that, I wanted to do this piece, Somewhere Over the Rainbow, What a Wonderful World, if I'm allowed to. It's kind of a short piece when you put it all together. So here we go. That you dream of once you're by. Somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly, and the dreams that you dream of, dreams really do come true. Star, wake up where the clouds are far behind me, where trouble melts like lemon drops. High above the chimney tops is where you'll find me. Somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. I see trees of green, red roses too. bloom for me and you. I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow so pretty in the sky, also on the faces people going by. See friends shaking hands, how do you do? They're really saying I love you. I hear babies crying, I watch them grow. They learn much more than I'll ever know. Think to myself, what a wonderful world. I think to myself,
Bob. I sing both of those songs when I go to assisted living places. We're going to have
Susan and Bob, it's your turn.
Oh. Sorry, didn't wait for your introduction, Harvey. I apologize.
If Bob Winkler plays, we follow him. That's just what we do.
Yes.
Our bad.
Do you do that all the time or just on Sundays?
Often. You'd be surprised how often.
Back to early Paxton. It's a long and dusty road, it's a hard and heavy load. Folks I meet ain't always kind. Some are bad and some are good, some have done the best they could, some have tried to ease my troubling mind. But I can't help but wonder where I'm best I can, trying to find what I was meant to do. And the faces that I see look as worried as can be. Looks like they are wondering too. And I can't help but wonder where I'm bound, where I'm bound. Can't help but wonder where I'm bound. Had a buddy way back home, but he started out to roam. I hear that he's out by the Frisco Bay. And sometime when I've had a few, his old words come ringing through. Going out to see him some old day. And I can't help but wonder where I'm bound, where I'm bound. Girl one time, she had lips like sherry wine, Oh, love me till my head went plumb insane. But I was too blind to see that she was slipping away from me. That my good girl ran off on the morning train. And I can't help but wonder where I'm bound, where I'm bound. Can't help but wonder where I'm bound. So if you see me passing by and you sit and you wonder why, wishing that you were a rambler too, just nail your shoes to the kitchen floor, lace them up and bar the door. Thank you, stars, for the roof that's over you. And I can't help but wonder where I'm bound, where I'm bound. Can't help but wonder where I'm bound. No, I can't help but wonder where I'm bound, where I'm bound. Can do a little Glenn Campbell, bring him back a little bit. He passed away a couple of years ago. Was this song about a cowboy country singer wants to rise to the top, be a rhinestone cowboy. I've been walking these streets so long, singing the same old song. No weary crack, dirty sidewalks of Broadway. Hustle, name of the game. Nice guys get washed away like the snow in the rain. I've been low to compromising. Shining on me like a rhinestone cowboy, riding out on a horse in a star-spangled rodeo, like a rhinestone cowboy, getting cards and letters from people I don't even know, and offers coming over the phone. Smile can hide all the pain. You're down when you're taking the train, taking the long way. And I'll dream of the things that I'll do. A subway token and a dollar tucked inside my shoe. I've been low to compromising on the road to my horizon. But I'm gonna be where the lights shining on me like a rhinestone cowboy. I'm riding out on a horse in the star-spangled rodeo, like a rhinestone cowboy, getting cards and letters from people I don't even know, offers coming over the phone. Walking these streets so long, singing the same old songs, and I know every crack in these dirty sidewalks of Broadway. Hustle's the name of the game. Nice guys get washed away like snow in the rain. Been low to compromising on the road to my horizon. But I'm gonna be where the lights shining on me. Riding out on a horse in the stars. Glenn Campbell for you. Written by Larry Weiss. Not Glenn.
And now up to the wilds of Queens, New York for Debbie and Ron.
Hot here. I don't know how hot it is in Florida.
Oh, it's actually cool down there. It's,
let's see. Better shut the fan. We have a fan and an air conditioner on. Better shut one off. Okay. Let's see if that works.
We're gonna start off with a.
All right. We're gonna do
with a
tune.
Fiddle tune that was.
And sorry, Robbie, you heard it already. But anyway.
they all sound the same.
Right, we used to play this often with
Roger always Sprung. Roger,
I love to hear you sing.
Yeah, thank you. It's an old time tune, and it was like his favorite tune. So we started playing it at one of his parties, one of the jams, and oh, I love that. That's my favorite tune. How'd you know? So he's gone for a year and a few days now. So we. Decided to do it for Roger. It's called Forked Deer.
If he was up there playing along on the harp or not, I don't know.
Definitely.
Yeah, right. Well, maybe he's got his banjo up there. So.
Yeah, they're rocking up there.
All right. Okay. What is this one? Okay. All right. I am going to attempt this on my dulcimer. I played it the other day. Sometimes I just can't play it. It's extremely painful in your old age to. With those hands, but anyway, I can do it once in a while. So this is an old Cy Conn song.
Now I'm going to play it on the harp.
He hides all the time.
What? You went mute. Wait a minute.
Okay. I don't know how much you heard. This is an old Cy Conn song. I try to play it on my dulcimer, which I managed to do it the other day. Okay. We're going to start with the tune, or what's the tune?
No.
Okay. It's called Gone, Gonna Rise Again. I'm not a lady.
I'm sorry.
To Sally in the Garden, old tunes.
Okay, thank you. Tricia, you ready?
Yeah, this is another old one that everybody will know. And kind of fits in with the previous one, which was fabulous, thank you. This is I'll Fly Away. Some bright morning when this life is over, I'll fly away to that home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away in the morning when I die. Hallelujah, by and by. I'll fly away. When the shadows of this life are over, I'll fly away. Like a bird from these prison walls, I'll fly, I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away in the morning when I die. Hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Oh, how glad and happy when we meet, I'll fly away. No more cold iron shackles on my feet, I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away in the morning when I die. Hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Just a few more weary days and then I'll fly away to a land where joys will never end. I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away in the morning when I die. Hallelujah, by and by. I'll fly away.
Yeah. Lovely.
Well, that was wonderful. Thank you, Tricia. Robbie, you're up.
Thank you. Sorry, I've had a number of interruptions, phone, visitors, whatever, but here I am and happy to be here. I was going to sing a song that I learned from Roger and Hal Wiley. Actually, the lyrics from Hal Wiley was one of their signature songs, and Drew and Rich Rini and I sang it with Triple Play. It's a contemporary gospel song, so ties in with what you're doing, Tricia. And let's see. It's called Sailing. For we are sailing from troubled waters to a glassy sea. We are sailing, and that is what my journey means to me. This life we travel through, the daily task we do, are but a sailing ship and nothing more. But if our ship is sound, we'll sail off glory bound and settle somewhere on that distant shore. For we are sailing from troubled waters to a glassy sea. We are sailing, and that is what my journey means to me. We fill the sails of life with the winds of joy or strife and chart a course to that far distant shore. We'll sail off to the night into a golden light, where the seas are smooth and calm forevermore. We are sailing from troubled waters to a glassy sea. Sailing, that is what my journey means to me. The winds may blow, and yet if heaven's force is met, we'll find the strength that points the chosen way. And when our journey ends, we'll gather with our friends and sing the songs of heaven on that day. For we are sailing from troubled waters to a glassy sea. We are sailing, and that is what my journey means to me. We are sailing from troubled waters to a glassy sea. We are sailing, and that is what my journey means to me.
Nice one.
Very nice, Robbie.
And now back from weeks of working on the railroad, it's time for Ina and Ray.
Oh, thanks very much. Yeah, sorry we've been away for such a long time. We've either been off somewhere being busy or exhausted from having been busy. But here we are, back, and we're going to do a song that we need to practice. And it's a song by one of our favourite songwriters, Careen Polwart, Scottish songwriter. And the song is called Follow the Heron, and it's set in the Hebrides, and just at the beginning of summer. So here we go.
The back of the winter is broken, and light lingers long by the door. And the seeds of the summer have spoken in gowans that bloom on the shore. By night and day we'll sport and we'll play and delight as the dawn dances over the bay. Sleep blows the breath of the morning away, and we follow the heron. We cradled our sorrows and we stoked all our fires with fear. Now those bones that lie empty and hollow are ready with gladness to cheer. By night and day we'll sport and we'll play and delight as the dawn dances over the bay. Sleep blows the breath of the morning away, and we follow the heron home. So long may you sing of the salmon and the snow-scented sounds of your home, while the north wind delivers its summon of ice and salt water and stone. By night and day we'll sport and we'll play and delight as the dawn dances over the bay. Sleep blows the breath of the morning away, and we follow the heron home. By night and day we'll sport and we'll play and delight as the dawn dances over the bay. Sleep blows the breath of the morning away, and we follow the heron home.
Pretty song.
Beautiful.
Thanks very much.
So we've just been doing it out in our choir at a concert and down on the quay as well.
Oh, fantastic. So was that today, Mike?
No, last Monday and the Monday before that.
Oh, brilliant. Oh, that sounds like fun, singing on the quay. Okay, we're going to do a song. I think we've done this before. I'm sure we've done it before, but it's a relatively new one for us. It comes from, I'm lucky enough to travel about a bit for work, and I was in Ireland and driving back to the airport, and I came across, I was stopped at a traffic light in a village called Tobercurry, and I looked up and saw a sign that said, "To the Famine Graveyard." And I thought, I must go and look at that. And it turned out that it's a workhouse graveyard, and I'm sure the workhouse and the famine were inextricably linked together. and the and it was a lovely place. It was a field, a couple of trees, a bench, very peaceful. And I had a look at the signboard, and it said that the last person to be buried there was buried in 1912, and she was thought to be about 60. And at the time, I was about 60, and I thought about the difference between my life and her life, and the fact that at age 60, she was still involved with the workhouse. And I thought, I really hope she's had some moments of happiness in her life, because the rest of it must have been pretty bad. And I sort of imagined her as this presence there in that field, waiting for someone to tell her that the world had been a had become a better place. And I thought, in some ways it has, and in some ways it hasn't. So this is about that, and it's called Rosie. Rosie Coughlan, and in Sligo I was born, and all I knew was poverty in this country once so strong. My mother died of hunger, and my father crossed the sea. I was sent to Tobercurry, a workhouse girl to be. Until we are free, I'm waiting in the garden for a new hope of liberty. I'm waiting where the valley meets the sea. Remember me. I met young Jimmy Sullivan when I was 23. Was working as a gardener in a mansion by the sea, and he'd take me to the gardens, and we'd dream there by the sea. But he went to fight the British, and he ne'er came home to me. Sunshine, but she cries for my despair and for people all around the world still trapped in famine's snare. Until they are rescued, until they are. Thank you.
All right, I guess it's Pat's turn now.
Yes, and before I start, I'd like to ask Anna and Ray to do a closing today and give you a little advance notice. I'd also like to request that the closing song be one of your original songs, if you don't mind. Anna, Ray? They're
there, but they're muted, so they can't.
Yes,
they can't answer.
That's fine.
Thank you very
much. We were thumbs upping.
All right, I appreciate it. Okay, so this song is a Tom Paxson song, "Last Thing on My Mind."
I just mute Mr. Drew over here. There we go.
It's a lesson too late for the learning, made of sand, made of sand. In the wink of an eye, my soul is turning. In your hand, are you going away with no word of farewell? Will there be not a trace left behind? Well, I could have loved you better. Didn't mean to be unkind. You know that was the last thing on my mind. As we walk, all my thoughts are a-tumbling. Round and round, round and round. Underneath our feet, the subway's rumbling. Underground, underground. Are you going away with no word of farewell? Will there be not a trace left behind? Well, I could have loved you better. Didn't mean to be unkind. You know that was the last thing on my mind.
You got
reasons aplenty for going. This I know, this I know. For the weeds have been steadily growing. Please don't go. Please don't go. Are you going away with no word of farewell? Will there be not a trace left behind? Well, I could have loved you better. Didn't mean to be unkind. You know that was the last thing on my mind. As I lie in my bed every morning, without you, without you. Each song in my breast dies a morning, without you, without you. Are you going away with no word of farewell? Will there be not a trace left behind? Well, I could have loved you better. Didn't mean to be unkind. You know that was the last thing on my mind. You know that was the last thing on
job, guys.
Nice. Very nice.
All right. I don't know what's going beep beep, but I think it's your phone in the charger.
Yeah. Sorry.
Did you take it out?
But after the song.
Okay. All right, well, this is a song from 1931 written by a guy named Gerald Marx. The name of the song is All of Me. All of me.
Why not take all of me? Can't you see?
I'm no good without you.
Take my lips. I want to lose.
Completed one fine rotation of the group, it's time for Murray again.
Okay. I get my notebook. And Bob and Susan sang a song by a song that Glenn Campbell made popular, which was the Rhinestone Cowboy. And by chance, I happened to pick for the second song also a song that was popularized by Glenn Campbell. But this one was written by Jimmy Webb in 1967. And it's called By the Time I Get to Phoenix. Okay. By the time I get to Phoenix, she'll be rising. She'll find the note I left hanging on her door. She'll laugh when she reads a part that says I'm leaving. Course I've left that girl so many times before. By the time I make Albuquerque, she'll be working. She'll probably stop at lunch and give me a call. But she'll just hear that phone keep on ringing off the wall, that's all. By the time I make Oklahoma, she'll be sleeping. She'll turn softly and call my name out low. And she'll cry just to think I'd really leave her, though time and time I've tried to tell her so. She just didn't know that I would really go. She just didn't know that I would really go. That's it.
Nice job.
Yeah. Oh, I believe we're up to Drew now in the wilds of New Jersey.
I'm going to do a Carter Family song. which I had first heard from Ed Trickett. And in singing the chorus, there's the word hallelujah. But he says the way to pronounce the word is hallelujah, like E-R-N. So I'm going to do it that way. I've got sweet heaven in my view, hallelujah. On my journey I press on, praise the Lord. I'm bound for that holy city. I've got sweet heaven in my view. I've got sweet heaven in my view, hallelujah. On my journey I press on, praise the Lord. I'm bound for that holy city. I've got sweet heaven in my view. My mother, she has died and she's left me. I'm all alone in this world, all alone. My father, he won't own me. I've got to find me another home. Got sweet heaven in my view, hallelujah. On my journey I press on, praise the Lord. I'm bound for that holy city. I've got sweet heaven in my view. My brothers and sisters, they don't know me. That's because I am crippled and blind. But I've got my ticket ready. I've got sweet heaven on my mind. Now when I arrive in heaven, I'm gonna take me a seat and sit right down. Gonna tell my Lord and my Savior I am looking for my robe and my crown. Got sweet heaven in my view, hallelujah. On my journey I press on, praise the Lord. I'm bound for that holy city. I've got sweet heaven in my view.
Thank you, Drew. George.
Thank you, Harvey. I'm going to try to lighten it up a little bit. I came across this song a couple of years ago for St. Patrick's Day. I don't know who wrote it, and I don't know who played it. I just heard it on the radio somewhere, and it's called The Bog Down in the Valley, Yo.
Rattling bog, bog down in the valley, oh. Oh, oh, the rattling bog, bog down in the valley, oh. Now in this bog there was a tree, a rare tree, a rattling tree. Tree in the bog down in the valley, oh. Oh, oh, the rattling bog, bog down in the valley, oh. Oh, oh, the rattling bog, bog down in the valley, oh. And on this tree there was a limb, a rare limb, a rattling limb, a limb on the tree, and the tree in the bog, and the bog down in the valley, oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. And on this limb there was a branch, a rare branch, a rattling branch, a branch on the limb, and the limb on the tree, and the bog down in the valley, oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. And on this branch there was a twig, a rare twig, a rattling twig, a twig on the branch, and the branch on the limb, and the limb on the tree, and the tree in the bog, and the bog down in the valley, oh. Oh, oh, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. Oh, oh, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. And on this twig there was a nest, a rare nest, a rattling nest, a nest on the twig, and the twig, twig on the branch, and the branch on the limb, and the limb on the tree, and the bog down in the valley, oh. Oh, oh, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. Oh, oh, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. And on this nest there was an egg, a rare egg, a rattling egg. The egg on the nest, and the nest on the twig on the branch on the limb on the tree in the bog down in the valley, oh. Oh, oh, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. Oh, oh, the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. And in this egg there was a bird, a rare bird, a rattling bird. The bird and the egg on the nest, and the nest on the twig on the branch on the limb on the tree in the bog down in the valley, oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. And on this bird there was a feather, a rare feather, a rattling feather, the feather on the bird, and the bird on in the egg, and the egg on the nest, and the nest on the twig, and the twig on the branch, and the branch on the limb on the tree in the bog, and the bog down in the valley, oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh, 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 the rattling bog, the bog down in the valley, oh. And on this feather there was a flea, a rare flea, a rattling flea, the flea on the feather, and the feather on the bird, and the bird in the egg, and the egg on the nest, and the nest on the twig, and the twig on the branch, and the branch on the limb, and the limb on the tree, and the tree in the bog, and the bog down in the valley, oh.
Yee-hoo!
Oh!
Yay!
I'm out of breath.
That was a foot tapper.
Thank you.
I'm a little surprised they didn't find a way to say something about the flea's legs, but all right.
I have a question.
I've heard a version with a hair on the leg of the flea. Yes.
I have a question for George. George, is that a left-handed auto harp?
Yes. This is a Tahoma. It was built by Pete Daigle, and he and I know each other pretty well, and he said, after I'd ordered it, he said, would you like to try a left-handed auto harp with right-handed fingering? So we did that, and it actually took me a lot longer to get used to playing it than I thought it would, but it's the first luthier harp that I ever owned. And so, yes, indeed, it's a left-handed harp, but it has the right-handed button layout.
Cool.
All right, thank
I just
you.
Turned mine around.
That was a great job, George.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Jerry, are you ready?
Indeed. Okay, so after this. I'm going to leave you because I have to go pack. And in answer to your question, Mike, we're not real near that spot where you're doing that festival, but if I can convince my friend to drive there, we will come and see you guys. I dare not drive in the UK. I tried it once and my head still hurts from it. Okay, lucky that's all that hurts from it, right?
Yeah, I realized you'd have to rely on your friends, yes.
Yes, yes, I have to rely on my friend. You know, believe me, you wouldn't want to watch me drive in the UK. It's a tragedy. I got an idea from Bob Winkler. So this is a little bit of a mashup, and you know these songs, so you have absolutely no excuse not to sing along. This is a departure from folk songs here. Sun. I'll be sitting when the evening comes, watching the ships roll in, and I watch them roll away again. Sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. I left my home in Georgia, headed for the Frisco Bay. Ain't got nothing to live for, looks like nothing's gonna come my way. Hey. Well, it's sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. Looks like nothing ever changed, everything remains the same. I can't do what 10 people tell me to, so I guess I'll remain the same. Well, I'm a sitting here resting my bones, and this loneliness won't leave me alone. 10,000 miles I roam just to make this dock my home. Hey, well, I'm a sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. I got sunshine on a cloudy day, and when it's cold outside, I got the month of May. I guess you say, what can make me feel this way? My girl, my girl, my girl, talking about my girl, my girl. I got so much honey, bees envy me. I got a sweeter song than the birds in the tree. I guess you say, what can make me feel this way? My girl, my girl, my girl, talking about my girl, my girl. I don't need riches, don't need no fortune or fame. I got all the riches, baby, one man can claim. Say, what can make me feel this way? My girl, my girl, my girl, talking about my girl, my girl. There we go.
Whoa.
Nice.
Throwback. See you guys soon. Get easy. And Mike, you never know. You never know. I mean, I suppose I could get on a bus. They know how to drive over there. But we'll
yeah,
see.
Yeah, that might be tricky going across the bridge on the bus. But
all right.
If you've got a few minutes, I'll put I'll put the my phone number on in chat.
Yeah, put it in the chat. Yeah, I've got a minute. Do that, and maybe we can call you when we're over there. That would be good.
And
I'm gonna do my song first, but good after that.
Jerry, remember to drink a pint for me.
Yeah. Well, listen, I'll drink a pint for you and for me. You've heard about the designated driver. I am the designated drinker.
Drinker.
That's my job. Yeah. That's my job.
Good job.
Nice work if you can get it.
Yeah.
Mike.
Yeah, the star of the county down. And it's topical, actually. Near Banbridge town in the county down one morning last July. Down the boring green came a sweet colleen, and she smiled as she passed me by. She looked so sweet from her two bare feet to the sheen of her nut brown hair. Such a winsome elf, I'm ashamed of myself, for to see I was staring there. From Bantry Bay up to Derry's Cay, from Galway to Dublin town, no maid I've seen like the fair colleen that I met in the county down. As she onward sped, sure a shack scratched me head, and I looked with a feeling rare, and I says I to a passer-by, who's a maid with the nut-brown hair. Well, he looked at me and he said to me, that's the gem of Ireland's crown, young Rosie McCann from the banks of the Bann, she's the star of the county down. From Bantry Bay up to Derry's Cay, from Galway to Dublin town, no maid I've seen like the fair colleen that I met in the county down. She'd soft brown eyes with look so shy, and smile like the rose in June. And she sang so sweet, what a lovely treat, as she lilted an Irish tune. At the Lammas dance I was in a trance, as she whirled with the lads of the town. And it broke me heart just to be apart from the star of the county down. From Bantry Bay up to Derry's Cay, from Galway to Dublin town, no maid I've seen like a fair colleen that I met in the county down. At the harvest fair she'll be surely there, so I dressed in my Sunday clothes, with my shoes shone bright and my hat cocked right, for a smile from the nut-brown rose. No pipe I'll spoke, no horse I'll yoke, till the plough is a rust-coloured brown. And my smiling bride by my own fireside, she's the star of the county down. From Bantry Bay up to Derry's Cay, from Galway to Dublin town, no maid I've seen like a fair colleen that I met in the county down. Thank you very much.
Ah, Bob Winkler.
Okay. This next song I've chosen, The Summer Wind, and no, not that kind of wind. We are in the monsoon season here in Arizona, especially southern Arizona, midsummer, and it's going to run through about mid-September. We got the nice breezes, the humidity, and the temperatures, so this is a song that Frank Sinatra made famous. Here we go. The summer wind came blowing across the sea. It lingered there to touch your hair and walk with me. All summer long we sang a song, and then we strolled that golden sand. Two sweethearts, summer wind, like painted kites, those days and nights they went flying by. World was new,
beneath the blue umbrella sky. Then softer than a piper man, one day it called to you. I lost you. I lost you to the summer wind. The autumn wind and the winter winds have come and gone. And still the days, those lovely days, they go on and on. And guess who sighs? His lullabies through nights that never end. My fickle friend, the summer wind. The summer.
It's time for the Susan and Bob show.
Yeah. Okay, I think I knew this song first by Ronnie Gilbert. I know it best by Judy Collins, but I've been listening to a Pandora station lately, having some fun with it. I of course, have a Harry Belafonte station. And he actually does a very interesting version of this song, but... that's neither here nor there. It's what put it in my head. I used to do it. Anyhow. I know where I'm going, and I know who's going with me. I know who I love, and my dear knows who I'll marry. I have stockings of silk and shoes of bright green leather, combs to buckle my hair, and a ring for every finger. Painted rooms are bright, and feather beds are bonny, but I'd trade them all for my handsome, winsome Johnny. Some say that he's bad, but I say he's bonny, fairest of them all, is my handsome, winsome Johnny. I know where I'm going, and I know who's going with me. I know who I love, and my dear knows who I'll marry.
Very nice, Ann.
Oh, lovely.
Well, I was going to do a song by Kate Wolfe for my friend Kathleen over there in England, but she's feeling under the weather today, so I guess I'll hold off till next week and kind of do it live for her. And so we folk singers can, you know, switch songs at the drop of a hat, you know, so. And songwriters, because this is about, I once thought about, you know, because I written a bunch of songs, nothing got notoriety, but, you know, it's just been something I had in my head all my life. And so when I get an idea, I write it down and try and make it into a song and whatnot. So this is a song about where do all these songs come from. So this is a song I wrote about 2 years ago, I think. Where do all the songs come from? I've written through the years. They come from all the things I've seen, the songs that I would hear. My songs are songs that come from songs, borrowed melodies and words. All songs are songs of others, of other songs that I have heard. Sad songs, funny songs, love songs too. Joan Baez, Bob Dylan, Phil Oakes, to name a few. Gospel ballads, lullabies, civil rights songs too. Woody Guthrie, Kingston Trio, and Judy Collins too. Where do all the songs come from? I write in measured rhymes. From writers' workshops, walks I took, open eyes and an active mind. My songs are songs that come from songs, borrowed melodies and words. All songs are songs of others, of the songs that I have heard. Sad songs and funny songs, love songs too. Pete Seeger, Brothers for Tom Paxton, to name a few. Gospel ballads, lullabies, civil rights songs too. Donovan, Hank Williams, and Belafonte too. Songs come from my strum and pick the strings. They come from life that I observe, pain and pleasure that it brings. My songs are songs that come from songs, borrowed melodies and words. All songs are songs of others, of the songs that I have heard. My songs are songs that come from songs, borrowed melodies and words. All songs are songs of other songs that I have heard.
All right.
Oh, it's time for Debbie and Ron.
Okay, here we are at the last second, trying to figure out what we're going to sing. I'm going to do this.
I'm going to do a song by Phil Staines. Of course, I didn't tune this thing.
All right. It is in the key of C.
Down the road last summer, with a
Song now in honor of our friend who just died a few days ago, one of our Florida friends. And so it was set to music by Randy Arbo in 1997, but it was written by the poet Alfred Lord Tennyson in the 1800s. And it's called Crossing the Bar. Boundless deep turns again home.
one may very far. I hope to see my pilot face to face when I have crossed the bar. When I have crossed the bar. When I have crossed the bar. I hope to see my pilot face to face when I have crossed the bar. When I have crossed the bar. When I have crossed the bar.
I hope to see my
Trisha, are you ready?
I'm poised. It's a bit difficult to sing this song after that song because we always sing that one in church. this is a reply to Bob mentioning funny songs. This is one of my funny ones. It's a Sid Kipper song, and it's a young man came courting me, as opposed to an old man. A young man came courting me, hey down, duvet down, wanted to marry me being young. He loved me for myself, despite my enormous wealth. Maids, when you're old, always wed a young man. He's got loads of phalerum, fal diddle hi harum. So maids, when you're old, always wed a young man. On the morn of our marriage vows, hey down, duvet down, he came round to my house, he being young. He ran upstairs, God bless, to help my young niece get dressed. Maids, when you're old, always wed a young man. He's got loads of phalerum, fal diddle hierum. So maids, when you're old, always wed a young man. We went to the wedding feast, ho down, duvet down. His kindness never ceased, he being young. In the back room he thanked my bridesmaids personally. Maids, when you're old, never wed an old man. They've got loads of phalerum, no diddle I dare'em. So maids, when you're old, always wed a young man. When all the guests were gone, hip down, duvet down, once more his breeding shone, he being young. He gave me some time alone while he walked my young friend home. Maids, when you're old, always wed a young man. He's got loads of phalerum, fal diddle hierum. So maids, when you're old, always wed a young man. When he came into bed, I thought, ha, down, duvet down, he'd be too tired for sport, he being young. He shouted four and blast, I opened my score at last. Maids, when you're old, always wed a young man. Then when he went to sleep, hang down, duvet down, out of bed I did creep, he being young. I left him in bed alone, cause there were four more like him at home. Maids, when you're old, always wed a young man. He's got loads of phalerum, fal diddle hierum. So maids, when you're old, always wed a young man.
Great.
The original is funny enough, but that's hilarious.
Yeah,
the other way around.
Yeah, when you're young, never wed an old man. But that was
that's cool. A little flip to me, but I'll take it the way it is. Robbie.
Yeah.
What happened? Go on mute, Robbie.
Harvey, we need you to unmute your microphone.
Right. One of the difficulties sometimes of being a songwriter is it's hard enough to remember the songs that you've learned over the years, but sometimes the songs that are hardest to remember are the ones you write. I don't know why that is, except maybe you have many different versions of them in your head, and it makes it harder. So I was going to try one of mine, but I think it's not really up to date. So I will sing a song that I did one recently. Apologies. Johnny Cash, I Still Miss Someone. At my door, the leaves are falling. A cold, wild wind will come. Sweethearts walk by together, but I still miss someone. No, I never got over those blue eyes. I see them everywhere. I miss those arms that held me when all the love was there. I wonder if he's sorry for leaving what we've begun. There's someone for me somewhere, but I still miss someone. No, I never got over those blue eyes. I see them everywhere. I miss those arms that held me when all the love was there. I go out to the party just looking for some fun. I stay in a darkened corner 'cause I still miss someone. No, I never got over those blue eyes. I see them everywhere. I miss those arms that held when all the love was there. I go out to the party just looking for some fun, but I'm so sad and lonely. Cold into the bone. No, I never got over those blue eyes. I see them everywhere. I miss those arms that held me when all the love.
Nice job.
Nice one,
yeah, nicely done. Robbie, I'm intrigued by your wallpaper.
Ah, that wallpaper is a painting.
It's amazing.
It's a painting. It's by an artist by the name of Wallace Ting. And it's quite large.
Yeah.
So it could look like, you know, wallpaper. Mm,
I mean, I was sort of using wallpaper in a general sense of backdrop to a picture. Uh-huh. I had a feeling it was something a little bit more interesting than that. That's really wonderful.
Yeah,
I love that.
I have several of his paintings in this room. Next,
oh, how
go
marvelous.
On a tour, okay?
Yeah.
But it's very nice because it's next to a patio, which looks out on the actual green garden. So it's in the summer especially, it's fun to see the two together. The kind of painted garden and the real garden.
Fantastic. Thank you, sorry.
Thank you.
Anna and Ray.
We're going to do another Corinne Polwart song because we like her and because we need to practice this one as well. This song is called Daisy. And it's about somebody who is a little bit naive and maybe a little bit too open. And the song is trying to get them to be a little bit more guarded. And I always have, I'm in two minds about singing it, really, because half of my brain, probably more than half of my brain, is always going, no, we all need to be a bit more like Daisy, not the other way around. So this is Daisy. Daisy, darling, don't spread your arms so wide. Why don't you keep a little something inside? I know you think that hands were made for pulling us through, but there are people in this world who don't think like you do. Hey, Daisy, darling, don't give them all you can. Why don't you few more cards in your hand? I know you'll only say things you believe to be true, but there are people in this world who don't think like you do. They don't think like you do, and some don't think at all. Daisy, darling, don't take it all as read. Why don't you ask a few more questions instead? I know you think that everyone should be paid what they're due, but there are people in this world who don't think like you do. They don't think like you do, and some don't think at all. Daisy, darling, don't spread your arms so wide. Why don't you keep a little something inside? I know you think that hands were made for pulling us through, but there are people in this world who don't think like you do. There are people in this world who don't think like you do. Very much. You may have become aware towards the end of that song that in the village where we live, summer is motorbike season. And we are fortunate enough to have the window right over there, which is open because it's hot, is this far away from the road. And so you might hear loud motorbikes, and they seem not to care at all that we quite like living in a nice quiet village. I mean, most of them are fine. There's just the occasional one that's really loud and doesn't seem to care. Anyway, next song. This is about, and I know we've done this one before as well. This is about an event in my mum's life, a little while after my dad died. And there's my mum, aged 80-something, living in a house by herself for the first time in her life. And needing a friend, and needing, as much as anything, someone or something to take care of. And this is called Dinner for Two. Suburbia is home. She was independent too, not afraid to live alone. And each one held inside a fierce and fiery pride. Both friends find life better now as their two worlds collide. Racing through the foggy streets, his amber eyes were bright. A speeding car, a dreadful crash, he fled into the night. No longer dignified to find a place to hide. Both friends find life better now as the two worlds collide. As she looked across the lawn, a shadow caught her eye. A wounded fox with straggly brush, thin and scared and shy. She quickly did decide her dinner to divide. Both friends find life better now as their two worlds collide. He still haunts the lanes and streets, strong again and free. But every day at 6 o'clock, he calls in for his tea. It fills her heart with pride, this lifeline to provide. Find life better now as their two worlds collide. Both friends find life better now as their two worlds collide.
Beautiful story.
Thank you.
One of my favorites.
He introduced himself originally by stealing a pack of sausages that my mum had been foolish enough to leave defrosting in the garden. The freezer was down at the bottom of the garden.
Okay, so our last songs are now, and then of course Anna and Ray have agreed to close the show. So this is Heart and Soul by Hoagy Carmichael and Frank Lozier. Harvey was saying Isn't this a song that every teenage girl likes to play, sit down and do a duet at the piano?
The answer is yes. Every teenage girl I ever knew.
So, Heart and Soul.
A friend of ours is a piano teacher, or was when he was putting himself through school. But he said, if there is a hell, it's filled with kids playing Heart and Soul on the piano over and over and over again.
And now you get to hear me trying it on a guitar.
We'll love it.
Lucky you.
Heart and soul, I fell in love with you, heart and soul, though a fool would do badly, because you held me tight and stole a kiss in the night. Heart and soul, I beg to be adored, lost control, and tumbled overboard.
I forgot to learn chopsticks for this week. I should have. Okay, this is from a guy named Todd Snyder. It's called Better Than Ever Blues. See. Except nothing at all. Same old climb up the same old walls. I've fallen down before. You see, I've been down, I've been so depressed, been overworked, been overstressed. But deep down here I know I must, 'cause I ain't gonna cry no more. Ignore. So call your buddies, call your friends,
Good song.
And now...
Announcements. Announcements for next week.
We have announcements for next week?
Yeah. That you're going to do it again.
I'm going to do it again. It's the same link. You get email and or notice on Facebook.
Right.
You get both, but, you know, it depends on what you got. And to close out, we have the willing victims graciously have agreed to sing the closeout song for us. Anyway, thank you.
I just would like to say I'll be away next weekend, so I won't be
okay.
here.
We'll miss you.
Forward to the next time.
We'll do the show.
I should be here, but I won't be doing anything new. I should be here, but I won't be doing anything new because I'll be down in Weston-super-Mare.
We're going to Weston as well, Mike.
I have a cake in the oven.
That's good.
We've been to every one since the first one, so my husband and I will be there.
Oh, okay. We're the Holly Shanty crew, you know that?
Okay. We'll look out for you.
Okay, take it away, Anna and Ray, please.
And we're off to a model railway show. In fact, I think we'll be where Mike normally is. And Mike will be somewhere
else. You're coming to my hometown, I'm going away.
Does that mean you're going to sing I've Been Working on the Railway?
No, we do have a railway song, but the one that we had ready, since we've done one about my mum, is one about my dad. So this is called Two Wrongs Don't Make a Right. My dad was a lovely chap. And he was the one who instilled into me this whole concept of the fact that you don't have to do an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. And it doesn't really work very well anyway. So two wrongs don't make a right. His name was John, grew up in London as a baker's son, in the free museums all day long, as often as he could. Became a man when he was 13 and the war began, joined the army, made a sergeant's rank, but was never sent abroad. Inside me now, as if he's by my side. Remember, if life knocks you down, two wrongs don't make a right. Two wrongs. Gentleman, quick to tell a joke or lend a hand, courage I would never understand until many years had passed. Redundancy, days he couldn't face reality, no one understood anxiety, perhaps we're getting there at last. Wisdom lives inside me now, as if he's by my side. Remember, if life knocks you down, two wrongs don't make a right. Two wrongs. Wisdom lives in inside me now, as if he's by my side.
Key for that song?
What chords are you playing there, Ray?
Good question.
No, what A. actual chords A are you
minor.
Playing?
A minor.
Yeah, A minor.
No, A wait. Minor, so B minor.
Yeah, D minor.
Yeah, A minor capo 2.
Thank you.
When I wish you heard that fiddle playing. It was
when
wonderful.
I wrote my first song, I was trying to figure out what chords you were using for that song because I just loved the chords, but I loved the song. Thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
And please give our best to Sol and Faye if anyone talks to them. And say we said hello.
Probably not. He's not sick or anything. He just has religious reasons why he's
not. I know. But it means he's not here and we can't say hello and sorry we've been away and all of that.